Shalom again. I want to look at how Mashiach HaRashah is our head as men, and the man is the head of the woman. And as such, and the Most High is the head of the Mashiach HaRashah. Let's look at St. John. Before we go there, go to Matthew 10 and we look at verse 32. Matthew 10 and 32. And it reads, "Whosoever therefore shall confess me, Mashiach HaRashah, before men, him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven." So he said, you confess Mashiach HaRashah before men, he will confess you before the Most High which is in heaven. That's why we're not supposed to cover our head. Who is Mashiach HaRashah? You confess him before men, he's going to confess you before the Most High which is in heaven. He's our head, Mashiach HaRashah. But whosoever, verse 33, but whosoever shall deny me before man, you want to cover me up before man, deny me before man, him, this is spiritual, him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven. See? So you want to cover up your head before man, you're going to deny you before the Most High. In closed quarters, you're going to cry out to the Most High in the name of the Lord and Savior, but before men, you don't confess him, so you're going to deny you before the Most High. So when you pray in the name of the Lord and Savior, he ain't even going to the Most High in the air. Because you done covered him up before men. The Most High has highly exalted him and given him a name above every name, in heaven and earth and under the earth. But you want to cover them up. Who's your head? Mashiach HaRashah, spiritually I'm talking. Luke 12 and 8. Luke 12 and 8. Luke the 12th chapter, the 8th verse. Also I say unto you, whosoever shall confess me before men, you confess your head before men, him shall the Son of Man, the Mashiach HaRashah, also confess before the angels of the Most High. So not only is he confess you before the Most High, but he confess you before the angels. You're being talked about to the Mashiach HaRashah, to the angels. Listen, this is a condition. And whosoever shall deny, but he that denieth me before men shall be denied before the angels of the Most High. So he that cover their head, who is a Mashiach HaRashah before men, you deny him before men, a Mashiach HaRashah will deny you before the angels. And he's coming back to tell you in Revelation 9:16 with 200 million angels. It's very important. That we see this because Mashiach HaRashah is our head. Second Timothy 2 and 12. Spiritually covering your head, man. Second Timothy 2 and 12. If we suffer, we shall all reign with him. If we deny him, he also will deny us. See? If we deny him, he also will deny us. That's covering up your head. With a covering over your head, the Mashiach Yahusha. Spiritually. Yes. Mark 8:38. Mark 8, chapter 38, verse. Mark 8:38. Whosoever therefore shall be ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. See? You want to be ashamed of your head, men, Mashiach Yahusha, in this adulterous and sinful generation? Of him also shall the Son of Man, Mashiach Yahusha, be ashamed when he cometh in the glory of his Father with the holy angels. To what? To judge and make war. So you want to cover your head up, Mashiach Yahusha? He's going to deny you before the Most High and before the angels. And you're going to be ashamed when he cometh with the glory of the Most High and with his holy angels. So you think he's going to redeem you? No. This ain't no some time to think. You're either for him or you're not. If you're for him, you're for your head, men. Then you confess him before men. If not, he's not going to confess you before the Most High. He ain't going to the Most High on your behalf. Everything got to be done decent and in order. In this order. Look at Matthew 25. When the Son of Man, who is the Mashiach Yahusha, shall come in his glory, the glory of the Most High, and all his holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. See? And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats. So when all these nations come together, he's going to separate all the nations, one from another, as a shepherd divideth his sheep from the goats. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand, but the goats on the left. See? But he's going to separate all the nations, just like what happened during the time of the Most High setting up all these kingdoms on the earth. Go back to Deuteronomy. 32:8. When the Most High divided to the nations, he didn't integrate everybody, he divided to the nations their inheritance. When he gave every nation their lands that they would live on. When he separated the nation, the sons of Adam. So he separated the sons of Adam, these nations. He didn't divide them. I mean, he didn't intermingle them and integrate everybody together. He separated the sons of Adam. He set the bounds of the people according to the number of the children of Israel. So he gave everybody their land. Once he gave all the children of Israel, he set up the lands that he's going to have for Israel. Then he gave the other nations their land. But the Most High's portion is his people. Jacob is a lot of his inheritance. Jacob is the forefather of the 12 tribes of Israel. So that's what Mashiach Yahusha is going to do. When he comes back, he's going to divide all the nations. Look, Matthew 35 and 32. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them. That's dividing the nations, one from another. As a shepherd divided his sheep from the goats. And he shall set the sheep on the right, his right hand, but the goats on the left. Then shall the king say unto them on the right, his right hand, which is the sheep of Israel, come, ye blessed of my Father. One way to be blessed of the Most High is to do what? Deuteronomy 28, 1 and 2. Deuteronomy 28, 1 and 2. And it shall come to pass, if, which is a condition, thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Most High thy power, to observe and to do all his commandments which I command thee this day, that the Most High thy power will set thee on high above all nations of the earth. Listen, and all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee if thou shalt hearken unto the voice of the Most High thy power. See? Deuteronomy 28, 1 and 2. That's how we're going to be blessed. If we hearken unto the voice of the Most High thy power to do what? To observe and to do all his commandments. His law, statute, commandments. That's how we're going to be blessed. That's when you look at Matthew 25. And 34. Matthew 25 and 34. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, come, ye blessed of my Father. Who is that? Deuteronomy 1 and 1 said, these be the words that Moses spake to all Israel on this side of Jordan. Say, come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. See, you're going to tell those that want to cover their head, don't want to highly exalt Mashiach Yahushua. That's what we're going to say to you. And verse 45. Then shall he answer them, saying, verily, verily I say unto you, truly I say unto you, inasmuch as ye did it not to one of the least of these, ye did it not to me. And these shall go away into everlasting punishment. That's the ones on the left side. The Dylan. Not follow the Most High's law, such commandments. And these shall go away into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal.
There it is.
You know how you're going to be righteous? Deuteronomy 6:25. So you want to follow the Most High's laws? You're going to go into eternal fire, as it said. Deuteronomy 6:25. And it shall be our righteousness. This is how you be righteous. If we observe to do all these commandments before the Most High, our power, as he has commanded us, that's how you be righteous. Not following your own ways, doing whatever you want to do. That's why you can't get ahead, because the Most High is not working with you. He ain't dealing with you. Look at Jeremiah 5 and 19. Jeremiah 5 and 19. And it shall come to pass when ye shall say, wherefore does the Most High our power all these things unto us? Why am I being dealt with like this? Why the Most High deal with me like this? Then shall thou answer them, like as ye have forsaken me and served strange gods, strange idols in your land, so shall ye serve strangers in a land that is not yours. Here we are.
So shall you serve strangers in the land that is not yours. Declare this in the house of Jacob, publish it in Judah, saying, Hear now this, O foolish people, and without understanding, which have eyes but see not, which have ears and hear not. Fear ye not me? As I say, you ain't afraid of me, said the Most High. Would ye not tremble at my presence, which have placed the sand for the bound of the sea by a perpetual decree, that it cannot pass it? And though the waves thereof toss themselves, yet can they not prevail? Though they roar, yet can they not pass over it? Through the Most High has made. But this people have a revolting and rebellious heart, rebellious mind, revolting and rebellious mind. They are revolted and gone. They just finished, you're gone. You're just gone. Revolted and gone. Neither say they in their heart, neither say they in their mind. Let us now fear the Most High. Let us be afraid of the Most High. Let us be scared of the Most High, our power that giveth rain, blessings, both the former and the latter, in his season. He reserved unto us the appointed weeks of the harvest. But your iniquities, your sins have turned away these things, and your sins have withholden good things from you. For among my people are found wicked men. They lay wait, as he that set of snares, set of traps. They set a trap. They catch men. As a cage is full of birds, so are their houses, full of deceit, lies, and so forth. Therefore, they are become great and waxing rich. That's how you let me know that they become rich by dealing with the deceit and the idolatry of these other nations. They are waxing fat. They shine, yeah, like all these, what they call, they got the show out, American Idol. They become celebrities, they become idols to the people. Shining, yeah. They'll overpass the deeds of the wicked. Now what you gotta say about that? Say they overpass the deeds of the wicked. They judge not the cause of the fatherless, those that don't have a father, yet they prosper. And the right of the needy do they not judge. Who's doing something for us as the Israelites? In the ghettos and slums, amongst all the millions and billions that they have in money. Shall I not visit for these things? Said the Most High, shall not my soul be avenged on such a nation as this? See, we've done things, we're doing things, and gonna do things that just displease the Most High. Well, he said, hey, you ain't gonna be afraid of me? You ain't gonna fear me? Y'all wanna think fear means something different. It means to be scared of, to be afraid of. That's why I say, you know, you gotta look at things spiritually besides just looking at them carnally. Be able to understand what's being said here. Romans 10 and 9. Romans 10 and 9. That if thou shalt confess with thy mouth, Mashiach Yahushua shall believe in thine heart, in your mind, that the Most High have raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. For with the heart, with the mind, man believeth unto righteousness. What's righteousness? We just defined it in Deuteronomy 6 and 25. To keep the laws of the Most High. And with the mouth, confession is made unto salvation. But if you want to cover up your head for Mashiach Yahushua, you ain't got nothing coming, because you're not going to the Most High on your behalf. You're not coming with the, you're not going to the holy angels who he's coming back with on your behalf. So you just on your own. Verse 11. For the scripture said, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. See? You're supposed to be ashamed to confess of Mashiach Yahushua, your head, before man. You better. He coming to judge and make war. Look at Acts 19 and 4. Acts 19 and 4. Then said Paul, John verily baptized with the baptism of repentance. Who did he tell, who did John baptize? For all the gainsayers. All you out there thinking that John the Baptist baptized anybody that came along. No, he didn't. Acts 13:24. When John had first preached before his coming, before Mashiach Abishai coming, the baptism of repentance to all the people of Israel. He only baptized Israelites. He was baptizing them, telling them to repent. See? Going back to Acts 19, you get understanding through the precepts. Acts 19 and 4. Then said Paul, John verily baptized, truly baptized with the baptism of repentance to the people of Israel, not no other nation, that they should be, that they should believe on him which should come after him, that is, on Hamashiach Yahushua. And when they heard this, they were baptized, every one of them, in the name of the anointed Savior. See? And that's how we all have to be baptized in the name of the anointed Savior, because the Father's in him, he's in the Father, and the Holy Spirit is going to testify of Mashiach Yahushua, will testify of the Most High. And he's speaking to us through Mashiach Yahushua in these last days, point blank. So it's very important that we don't cover our head, men, up so that we don't fall into this category right here. When the judgment comes, you don't want this to be you. In Matthew 7 and 21, these are the words of Mashiach Yahushua. He said, not everyone that said unto me, Mashiach, Mashiach, or Yah, whatever name, Yahushua, whatever name that you use pertaining to calling on him. Not everyone that says unto me, Mashiach, Mashiach, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father which is in heaven. What the Most High would just say? Hark to his voice, keep his commandments. Many will say to me in that day, Mashiach, Mashiach, have we not prophesied in thy name, in the name of the anointed Savior? And in the name of the anointed Savior cast out devils, and in thy name done many wonderful works? So people are going to be doing this. But remember what we have went over so far. Verse 23, and then what I profess unto them, I never knew you. Depart from me, ye that work iniquity. That's very important. Can't cover them up. Can't cover your head, brothers and sisters. At least brothers, I'm talking to brothers, because the head of the woman is the man. But as far as the head of the man, it's a Mashiach Yahushua. He told us in 1 Corinthians 3 and 23. Verses 3:23. And ye are Mashiachim. And Mashiach is the Most High. See, we belong to Mashiach. Mashiach is the Most High. So understand this, and pretty much, hopefully that was a little bit. I have a lot more, but you know, that's why I'm gonna stop on that particular subject of what we were dealing with concerning men wearing mitres and bonnets and certain things on their heads. Okay? So long.